Hi friends, so in this video I am going to explain you about Vaughan Richter rearrangement. Now this rearrangement is actually conversion of aromatic nitro compounds into corresponding carboxylic acid group, and this is carried out in presence of cyanide ion such as potassium cyanide in aqueous ethanol. But the main thing in this rearrangement is that carboxyl group enters with sign substitution, means it will always be ortho with respect to the leaving group and never meta or para. So the conversion of aromatic nitro compounds in presence of cyanide ion in aqueous alcohol into corresponding carboxyl acid with sign substitution is known as Vaughan Richter rearrangement. And this particular rearrangement gives very good results when electron withdrawing groups are present at ortho and para positions. But the main drawback of this rearrangement is that it is the yield is very low. So this rearrangement is generally not preferred. So this is the general reaction. Here we need to take any aromatic nitro compound. This Z is some electron withdrawing group such as halogens or any other group. So in this particular example, the Z group is present at para position with respect to nitro group. Here the most important thing that we need nitro group. Okay. So when this aromatic nitro compound is treated with potassium cyanide in aqueous ethanol, then it leads to formation of sine substituted carboxylic acid. Now I will tell you what is sine substitution. Like we give ortho, meta and para position. So here what happens, you can see in the product nitro is not present. So there is elimination of nitro group. Now in the starting material the position is para, while in the product they are at meta position with respect to each other. So generally it is kind of substitution reaction, but you can see here that nitro group is not displaced by COOH group, means COOH is not taking the position of nitro group. Actually it is taking the adjacent position, that is ortho position with respect to nitro group. So that kind of substitution is called as sine substitution, C-I-N-E. So this is Vaughan Richter rearrangement, conversion of nitro compound into carboxylic acid with sine substitution. Let's discuss the mechanism. So here I have written the elaborate structure of this aromatic nitro compound. First step is a nucleophilic attack of cyanide ion. So this cyanide ion will attack at ortho position with respect to nitro group. Now when it attacks here, these pi electrons will shift between carbon and nitrogen to form a double bond, and this oxygen will acquire a negative charge and we get this intermediate. Now there is most important thing, you must be thinking that in the product here you can see there is formation of carboxylic acid and we are using cyanide. So you may think that cyanide will, there is introduction of cyanide on this aromatic ring, and then cyanide will undergo hydrolysis. But actually this does not take place. See, if we have cyanide group, so generally if we do hydrolysis, we add two molecules of water, so that will lead to formation of carboxylic acid and the byproduct will be ammonia. But in this particular rearrangement, it was found that ammonia is not formed. Instead of ammonia, there was evolution of nitrogen gas. So evolution of nitrogen gas and absence of ammonia confirms that hydrolysis of cyanide ion is not taking place. That's why this rearrangement is very important. So when I'll explain you mechanism, then you will understand that why we are getting only a nitrogen gas evolution and not ammonia. So this, as I told you, cyanide ion will attack at ortho position with respect to nitro group and there will be negative charge on both the oxygen atoms and nitrogen will have positive charge. Now you can see here this is benzene ring which is aromatic in nature. So when this, there is nucleophilic attack of cyanide ion on this benzene ring, then the molecule which we get, that becomes non-aromatic in nature, means that is not aromatic in nature. You can see it is not aromatic. So next step is deprotonation. Now on this carbon atom there is one hydrogen attached, so this proton will be eliminated and these sigma electrons will shift here and thereby neutralizing the positive charge on nitrogen atom. So we have converted this this ring which was not aromatic in nature into aromatic ring. So we got back the aromaticity of the molecule. Once we get this, then the next step is attack of this negatively charged oxygen atom on this electrophilic carbon atom. So in case of cyanide ion, this carbon atom is electrophilic in nature. So next step, the driving force is negative charge on oxygen atom, which will attack on carbon atom, leading to formation of a 5-membered heterocyclic ring. And there will be negative charge on this other oxygen and negative charge on nitrogen atom. Now, since there are negative charges, that means it is quite unstable. So next step will be protonation. So in that, the driving force is negative charge on the second oxygen atom, which will shift here. This bond will break, it will migrate between carbon and oxygen to form a double bond, and this will shift here. So what will happen? First we get carbon nitrogen single bond and there will be negative charge on nitrogen atom. So that nitrogen will abstract first proton. Even after abstracting first proton, there will be a negative charge, still there will be a negative charge on nitrogen, so that will again abstract the second proton. So basically what is happening, there is cleavage of nitrogen oxygen bond and there is formation of amide functional group. So we get this. So this is benzamide derivative. You can see here benzene ring and we have this amide functional group. So this is benzamide and here we have nitroso functional group. It is NITROSO, nitroso functional group. So there was evidence of formation of this nitroso group and also for the formation of benzamide, which confirms that in the reaction there is no formation of ammonia. Once we got this molecule, which is quite stable and this can be isolated, so by doing spectral studies it was observed that this is formed as an intermediate product in this particular rearrangement. The next step is, now nitrogen of amide functional group, it is nucleophilic in nature, it contains lone pair of electrons, so that will again attack on this nitrogen and oxygen will acquire negative charge. Now what will happen, then there will be intramolecular proton transfer. So basically what is happening, there is loss of a water molecule, water molecule is eliminated and we get a double bond between these two nitrogen atoms. So again one more 5-membered ring will be obtained. So it's like benzopyran kind of intermediate, this can also be isolated. Next step is, now we are carrying out reaction in basic conditions. So we have hydroxide ion, or you can see in previous step there was formation of a water molecule. So water can act as a nucleophile, so from that we can get OH minus. So that OH minus attacks on this electrophilic carbonyl carbon and oxygen acquires negative charge. We get this intermediate. You can see here there is negative charge on oxygen atom and introduction of hydroxyl group. In the next step, the negative charge on oxygen is the driving force. So that will shift here. This bond between carbon and nitrogen will break and you will get a triple bond between these two nitrogen, and the bond between other carbon and nitrogen will also break. So what is happening? There is cleavage of this 5-membered ring and evolution of nitrogen gas. Now what happens here? We get a carbon ion. You can see on this ring there is negatively charged carbon atom. So we got a carbon ion, and in the reaction mixture proton is present. So last step is protonation. This carbon ion will abstract the proton and we get our sign substituted product, which is a carboxylic acid. So there is loss of or elimination of nitro group. Now you see in previous step there is evolution of nitrogen gas. Nowhere ammonia was present. So there was like ammonia was absent, and that indicates that it is not simple hydrolysis of nitriles. So this rearrangement is von Richter rearrangement. I hope you have understood the mechanism. So here I have given you one application. So here with respect to this nitro group at para position, there is methyl group. Okay, so this is para nitro toluene, which is treated with potassium cyanide and aqueous ethanol. What you have to do is you just remove nitro group, and with respect to nitro group, whichever is the ortho position, on any one of the ortho position, you introduce carboxylic acid group. Now suppose this ortho position is already blocked, here also one methyl group is present. So your product will be COOH will be over here. And suppose if both the ortho positions are blocked, then in that case reaction will not occur. Okay. So here ortho positions with respect to nitro group should be vacant, that is main criteria. If any one position is blocked, so reaction will occur. If both the positions are blocked, then the reaction will not occur. So here I have put up two questions. You please complete both of these questions and write the mechanism. Simple thing, remove nitro group and introduce COOH group at ortho position with respect to nitro group, you will get your product. Okay. I hope you have understood this von Richter rearrangement. It is quite easy. If you have any doubt, you can put it in comment box. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you so much.